One championship dawn of heroes live from Manila in the Philippines was the biggest night in Philippines martial arts history and proved everything we hope it would and a whole lot more. It was a night jam-packed with the finest martial arts action we have ever seen. Hello everybody, Michael Schiavello alongside the VP of One Championship, Miesha Tate, and we're also joined by the chairman and CEO of One Championship, Chatri Sitchatong. Chatri, tonight, the biggest night in Philippines martial arts history, it lived up to and beyond all expectation.
It was electrifying, it was shocking, it was just off the charts. I mean, the action, the nail-biting finishes, the reversals of fortune, we had it all. I mean, Philippines and the rest of the world, that was a special, special treat.
Folks, it was amazing from start to finish, from top to tail. There were so many highlights to pick out of an extraordinary night. And the way we finished the night with Martin Nguyen retaining the featherweight world title with a highlight reel finish over Koyomi Matsushima. Martin Nguyen, Miesha, put the title on the line. We know what a dominant champion he is. We know that overhand right he possesses. Also, his tremendous defense. It all came into one superb package for the champion tonight after a strong start, though, from Matsushima.
Oh, it was a great battle, a war of attrition. Both those athletes went out there and laid everything on the line. And, the tremendous show of respect at the end of it really sealed the deal for me. I thought this was a spectacular bout to cap off an already fantastic night.
And Chatri, as you were saying to me earlier on, Martin Nguyen is the real deal. And since he's gone to Hard Knocks in Florida, he is a completely different martial arts beast.
You know, today Martin's wrestling takedown defense was definitely tested. Koyomi is a high level wrestler, and Martin showed his true colors. And you could just see it, you know, after a few takedowns, Martin got the beat, and then that was it. And wow, I mean, he literally lit Koyomi up, didn't get touched. Martin is the real deal.
Speaking of wow moments tonight, the co-main event between Jonathan Haggerty and Rod Sanchipwainong gave us, I feel, one of the best One Super Series matches we have seen yet. This was for the Muay Thai World Flyweight title held by Jonathan Haggerty. Two 22-year-olds, Chatri, and they're at just the highest peak in the Muay Thai world. This was the match of matches for me. This was incredible.
It was, you know, it styles makes fights, and these guys came to bang. You know, it was in the very beginning, it looked like Haggerty was gonna use his reach, his push kick to keep Rotang off balance and stuff, but Rotang turned it really up, you know, in the third and fourth and fifth rounds. You could just see it, and man, what a fight.
Miesha, we said that on commentary, that traditionally when it's a five-rounder, the Thais do start slow for the first two rounds. They pick it up in the third round. That's what Rotang did. And I think the real time changer was the knockdown of Haggerty, because like Chatri said, and like Mitch and I said, the first two rounds was all Jonathan Haggerty, and then the tide turned with the knockdown.
It sure did, and I think that was a 10-8 round, because that was a really clean knockdown. And that's when I feel like he really started to find his rhythm. You know, he marched forward, he landed those big right hands and the hooks, the body shots. He really started to put everything together, and his pace was just relentless. He just rolled into the momentum, and it kept moving and it kept going forward. It was just really, at the end of the day, too much for Haggerty to handle.
Chatri, if Hollywood directors were watching tonight, I think there's one match they'd want the script to. That was Eddie Alvarez and Edward Filiang. This was just amazing, because you had Alvarez and Filiang both coming off losses last time out in Japan, both on the road to redemption, both hoping for a final spot in Tokyo in October. Eddie Alvarez goes down from a leg kick. I thought he was done for all money. Somehow, he turns it around and ends up subbing out Filiang.
You know, I tell you, the mark of greatness is how you handle adversity. And Eddie Alvarez was literally one or two punches away from lights out. He was dominated early, outstruck by Edward Filiang, and somehow did a half guard, I believe it was a half guard sweep, and came out on top and passed, and the night was over. I mean, just beautiful jiu-jitsu with the back, in terms of how he just flattened out Edward, lifted up the chin by the forehead, just really technical. So, man, kudos to Eddie. He's again, one of the greats in history.
Miesha, were you like the rest of us? Did you think when he took that leg kick and he was down, like, oh, that's it, Eddie's gone, it's done for him, his night's over?
No doubt about it. I thought it was going to be a quick night. I thought it would be an early night for Eddie Alvarez, but he showed exactly why he is the underground king, that he can be a live wire, really a live dog in any situation. He can turn it around. He is a champion. He has a championship mentality, has a championship heart, and really that's what we saw on full display today.
Speaking of live wires, how about the King Danny Kingad, the king without a crown, but he is now one step closer. Danny Kingad in one of the tightest decisions of the night, edging out Aussie Reese McLaren in the Flyweight World Grand Prix semi-final. He books his place in Tokyo. But first of all, Demetrius Johnson, Tatsumitsuwada. Let's look at that one first, though. Demetrius Johnson had some real problems here, Chatri. And a lot of people thought very early on that Demetrius was losing before he managed to turn the tide.
No, absolutely. He was definitely, I think, within the first 5 minutes, it was clear that Wada's length, you know, even the underhook, how high he had DJ's arm within standing position, right? And he was able to get the back. It was just incredible. I mean, Wada is the real deal. And the thing is, look, DJ has faced adversity before. He is a world champion. He is, pound for pound, the greatest in history. We expected nothing less from DJ. It does not matter how the fight starts, how it ends. And DJ dominated the last two rounds completely. I mean, he was just, he showed again why, literally, why DJ is one of the greatest ever.
Chatri, we'll leave it there for you. I know you're a busy man. Thank you for joining us in this great recap of what was the biggest night in Philippines martial arts history from here in Manila. Folks, we're going to be back in a moment with more great highlights for you. Plenty more action coming your way. But right now, take a look at this. Reese McLaren. Danny Kingad's performance was exceptional. Reese came agonizingly close.
This was the match of the night for me. Absolutely, hands down. I think it stole the show. I mean, Reese McLaren is a savage on the ground. His submission ability down there is crazy. But Danny Kingad, I was blown away. Not only did I think that he would have the advantage on the feet, but I think the surprising part was when he chose to take this to the ground with the BJJ black belt. I mean, really, that says something about the mental fortitude of Danny Kingad, that he wanted to break Reese McLaren, and he was able to edge that out. I think it was the right decision. At the time, I was questioning it. But I think now, I mean, it showed. I think if he would have stood and break, it may not have gone his way. But he dominated the top, and it was just an incredible, incredible, spectacular bout.
So here's the graphic of the moment, folks. The bracket as it stands. Demetrius Johnson eliminated Wada tonight. Danny Kingad eliminated Reese McLaren. And now we have an epic final in Tokyo. Come October 13, Demetrius Johnson versus Danny Kingad. And the great one, the GOAT, the Mighty Mouse, DJ's with us. DJ, congratulations. Mate, what a tough contest for you. As Chatri said, as we said, the first 5 minutes was rough.
First 5 minutes was rough, man. Trying to get my distance, you know, Tatsumitsuwada, he's a very long opponent. So I think he's been, the last time I fought somebody that height was back in 2011. It was Miguel Torres. So trying to get used to him. And also the thing that surprised me the most about him is that how long he was and his leverage.
You said it was a disappointing performance from you tonight. Out of 100, what do you rate yourself? A 70, a 60, an 80? What was it tonight?
I mean, it wasn't a disappointment. It was just that I just was content in being in certain situations. Like when he got my back, and I'm right there, he's got my back. I'm okay, you got my back. What are you going to do? Right here, I was on one leg trying to like get my right leg out, but his legs were so much longer, I couldn't get him out. But even here, you know, it's just hard. It's a different type of fight. And, you know, not all of them are going to be easy, and I couldn't impose my will on him because he was just so much longer than me. So, but it was a fun fight. I learned a lot, and can't wait for the finals. And I always want to finish my opponents. I train so hard, I'm going for the finish. I'm not trying to go to the judges' scorecards.
Well, sitting on the other side of the bracket, there's Danny Kingad. You had a great performance tonight, I think. I know you're always a bit hard on yourself, but you know, Danny Kingad really showed that he's a legit contender. He's a legit opponent. Like, what's your thoughts on that?
100%. I think Reese McLaren and Danny Kingad, that was a great fight back and forth in the wrestling department. Obviously, Danny Kingad is more of a stand-up artist, and so I know I got my hands full in Tokyo, Japan, and I'll go home and my body heal and prepare the best I can to take on the little phenom.
DJ, have a good time at home. I know you go straight back into camp. We'll see you, mate, October 13 in Tokyo, Japan. Thank you very much. The great Demetrius Johnson through to the final in Japan.